Hiya folks, we're starting at the Fox and Hounds pub today. Air's a bit cold. It just looked like a kind of dry, milky, overcast day when I was back at the house. And I decided, you know, maybe I can squeeze in a moor walk today for once. Haven't been able to do many of them this year. And I haven't done one for March, I realised, so better late than never. So I'm going to walk the Rattlebrook Tramway. This will be a revisit. And I don't have my tarp with me, unfortunately. I think I'll save my tarp for later in the year. If I do end up getting a car, then I can tarp it in more dramatic places, I guess. Although parts of the Rattlebrook Tramway can be pretty dramatic. Anyway, I think the first time I went on that tramway was the video Grentor, Green Tor, Donegoat tours. And I might have gone there a second time or a third time. What did I see? Yeah, I might have gone to Kitty Tor, gone part way up the tramway to get to that. Today I might see if I can just walk the whole length of the tramway, I guess, all the way to the end of it. I think it might be muddy on the moor. There's been rain, but there's a little bit of a chilly wind around. We'll see if that dries the ground. And my dumb weather app on my phone, which for some reason comes from Norway. Best one I could find, it's still crappy. It's like Norwegian weather service forecast for the world, I guess. It says it's going to be sunny from 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock onwards, all the way to sunset. But temperatures 9°C, 10°C, so still kind of cold. But in the sunshine, that's going to feel quite nice. Beginning at just around 1 o'clock. Here we are, once again at Nodden Gate. I haven't checked any firing times, but I don't think Rattlebrook Tramway is on the firing range. No, I think you have to get up to Doe Tor and that, don't you? To be fired upon by the British military. Oh, that was an easy open today. I swear that was harder to open in the past. Oh well. Right. Here we are, on the open moor. I'll try and get to, I think, the King Way now. Let's have a look at the map so we can see where I'm going.
There we go. Trusted the MC map. It's pretty easy today. There we go. We started here. Come up here to Nodden Gate. Start going up the King Way, which is a nice one. You can also take the right one if you want to get to Great Nodden. I've done this quite a lot. Passing Great Nodden, as you know, if you've seen these, keep going until this thing completes where the way you turn, the Rattlebrook Tramway goes all the way around here. Past Hunt Tor, past Woodcock Hill, and then ends. I think it goes to Kitty Tor, but it doesn't, it sort of ends. You have to go past loads of ponds if you want to go to Kitty Tor. Actually, this map seems to be saying the King Way is called that all the way up, which I didn't know. I thought it became the Rattlebrook Tramway here, actually, but I guess not.
I wonder if this thing here, because there's like a buried structure there, I wonder if this thing, this lump here, was the, what do you call it? The thing that the British Army used to hide in for their nuclear test things. There's one on Sharper Tor, I think, or is it Peak Hill? Peak Hill, I think. And there's maybe another one here, and this looks awfully like it could be it. But I saw some maps or something saying that it would be up here. If so, what's this? Because it looks awfully similar. The structure to the Peak Hill one.
this is like a buried, it looks like a buried building to me.
It seems to go down quite a bit. Get a light in there. Yeah, never really known what that is, but that seems more like that. What is it called? Royal Observer Corps or something? Yeah, it's Royal Observer Corps, because I get it mixed up with Republic of China, because it's ROC. Yeah. That's what I think that might be, to be honest. Anyway, we're up on the Kingway now. The ground doesn't feel too bad here, but I think it's going to be muddy further up. Like a trench here. Square bottom trench. Not seen that before. Well, this wind is kind of biting, cold, icy, dry wind, so I'll be glad of getting some sunshine if we're gonna later on the trip. See, on maps I've seen, I can't really see over this wall here, but I'm sure I saw a map saying the Royal Observer Corps underground bunker building was like meant to be in the top of one of these fields here. But if that's true, then what the hell is that lump right next to Norden Gate? It looks like the thing. I wonder if there's a good way to see over that wall. Probably have to get to Great Norden and look down for it. Sunset has hit, my dudes. We finally got a blast of sunshine everywhere except Bright Tor Widgery Cross over there. There's different ways to see these walks. I think three or four come to mind right now. One is geographical, like there's this unknown place called Dartmoor where you've never been. And so, age of exploration style, and even though loads of other people have done it before you, you don't know what's up there, you see maps, you want to look at the maps and go, wow, what the heck is that? Let's see it in person. Get down there, you go to it, you conquer it, you know, you bag the tour, and you've been there, and your geographical sense has expanded, but sadly, the mystery sense, the enigma and all that is shrunk as you know where you are. And eventually, like me, you know everything on Western Dartmoor. There's a lot less places where you can get lost or be in a enigmatic landscape where you don't know what's there. Second way of viewing, walking out here in the landscape, is kind of a depressing sort of way. The authoritarian, like the evil that humans can do. You look at the landscape and you see a sign saying, don't go here, don't camp here, no lighting fires, no taking your dog to this place, no feeding the animals, no approaching the sheep, you know. It's a very modern contrivance. It's like in the old days of the, let's say, between the Victorian era and the early 1990s, there was a lot less of this stuff telling you what you can and can't do and where you can and can't go. And then you see like how man is... Okay, let's say this is a third way. Third way of seeing landscape. You see how man has shaped the land. Like, you realize that as far into nature as you think you can get in your own country, you can't get into nature. Because everything here, if you define humans as being the non-nature, the unnatural. I mean, if you define humans as nature, then the space shuttle is a natural formation. If you define humans as non-nature, then all these tracks, the little trenches and mining divots in the land, the old tin mine ruins, even like settlement things, whatever you call them, the Stone Age settlements and stone rows, they're all humans ruining the landscape and forming it into their shape. Like that other track that's running along parallel to me. Under that brow to Great Noddon is very much a man-made thing. You can see it's just been dug and they've used dynamite to dig into the ground to shape where that ancient railway used to be, that isn't now. So you look at the landscape in that way. Like, everything is touched by humans. You cannot get back to the nature that humans first enjoyed when they were hunting mammoths and things, and learning what tools and fire do. Okay, so I think that was 3 out of 5 ways you can view the landscape. Let's try and remember the other two. Another way you can view the landscape, which is the way I view the landscape quite often when I'm in a happy mood, is the futuristic. Like, what in a futuristic utopia, what could this world become? And that does kind of go hand in hand with how humans shape the landscape. It acknowledges that humans are natural, not non-natural, I suppose. So the space shuttle is natural, and all these little tracks and mine workings and things, you acknowledge that those are natural and that humans are part of the natural world, and they will naturally do this to the landscape now that we're here. And you go further than that, like accelerationism. What happens if the humans just kept going? And so a skyscraper might appear on a tour, or a giant white spire church, or the wind farms will get more massive and multitudinous. Maybe Dartmoor will become like Mega City 1 from Judge Dredd, or maybe it'll become more like some kind of art piece. I mean, you can already see the beginnings of something like that with the cross on Braptor, Widgery Cross. It's not even like an old religious marker stone, it's an art installation for the Queen. I can't remember if it's Queen Victoria, was it? Or if it was Queen Elizabeth. One of the two. Anyway, it doesn't really match up with the other crosses that you find on the moor, which are like, I don't know, parish boundary markings, graves, church kind of markings on the landscape. Little things with stories like Stephen's grave or Charlie's tomb near Fox Tor. It's like, Braptor Widgery Cross isn't one of those. It's, by the way, not going up Great Noddon. Kingway still. It's like an art installation, so some may argue it's one of those things that's not meant to be there. Like if you put a wind farm on the moor, or if you built a skyscraper on the moor. But you could get yourself into the mindset where you accept a degree of futurism, and it's like how the Amish, they choose a degree of technology. People say the Amish are non-technological, they have no technology in their lives, but they have tons of technology in their lives. They have farming equipment, they have tools, they have books, they have like paintbrushes, like all this is technology. So when you're talking about technology, you have to define what the heck you mean, what degree of technology you mean. So in the far future, Dartmoor could become a scummy, horrible city metropolis like San Francisco or Mega City 1 from Judge Dredd, or like the skyscraper Chicago World from The Matrix. So I have to cross some water here. Or it could become a different version of the futuristic world where, like, I don't know, it's all kind of art installations and things that someone has decided artistically fit in with the look of Dartmoor, to adapt it to some new aesthetic or something that they've decided upon. Or with me, like my version of that, if we had to do it, would be more a link with the space age, like an Arthur C. Clarke world, basically. If you read his books, he's got various things where parts of the countryside are preserved, but humans are deep into the space race. And there's like a space elevator base in the countryside that people go to, and it's semi-rural, despite what it is, but people use it to get up to to the low Earth orbit atmosphere to get to like space basically, and have a hotel up there in space, and you can jump on a spacecraft to Mars from that point. So that's another way of viewing Dartmoor if you want to go that far. And the fifth way of viewing Dartmoor would be, what's the ugliness of the landscape like? Not just Dartmoor, it's like the Lake District, Scotland, wherever you are. If you go away from the cities into the countryside, then you're in supposed freedom, although it's not freedom. You've got, what's the ugly side of Dartmoor? Well, animal shit everywhere, just coating the landscape, even more so in August. You know, a wasp might attack you, you might get lost, you might go into a bog and fall like waist deep into a bog and it would ruin your day. You might be out in the rain, and like this year it's been raining for 2 months solid, and you might get out halfway through that 2 months solid and think, you know, I'm just gonna get out, man. Like Hayes Outdoors did in his recent video, check that out. You know, it's been raining torrentially forever and you go, ah, England is so gross, it's raining all the time. I've been cooped up indoors because I didn't want to go outside for a walk on the moors or in the woods, because it's just so much rain, it's gonna be muddy, there might be fog, I might actually not see any views, so what's the point? It's gonna be a bad time. And so you get out there anyway and you challenge yourself and you have a little bit of fun. But once you come home again, you know, what if it's just still raining forever for another 2 months on end? And you're like, oh, man, I really wish I lived in a place like Arizona where it was almost always sunny and it's always dry and you can get out, as long as you don't mind the heat too much, you can get out anytime you want. So there's that aspect. More ugly sides of the countryside, you could just like want to get from A to B, and you might not want to follow the tracks and stuff where people expect you to go, so you go out into, say, that sort of landscape. Or up here, there's like the worst landscape on Dartmoor. I'm going to be passing it later, I think, between the Railbrook Tramway and Hunt Tool. You know, what if you just wade into what you think is just going a little bit off-road to get from A to B to something you can see, and you just suddenly find yourself stuck in the worst terrain imaginable, and you just start slowing down, and eventually you stop and you go, you know, I don't think I'll be able to make it to that thing I can see right in front of me, because the terrain is so bad that I'm going to twist an ankle, get stuck, the air ambulance is going to have to come out to me, I'm going to try and get a signal on my phone to phone people I know to come out to me, I have to tell them navigationally where I am on Dartmoor, and it's going to be a pain in the ass. And then there's other things like, oh, you're walking your dog and your dog that you've brought with you decides to like roll in some moorland shit, dive into the muddiest river or bog you can think of, and it comes back home with you and you've got to deal with that. So there's like, there's an ugliness you have to accept from Dartmoor in order to decide that there's like a beauty about it. I'm not going to full on sorry Max Piper. Max has got some of his social media accounts are called Beautiful Dartmoor, but there is an ugly side to Dartmoor. I mean, I'm not going to lie, but if you accept those ugly factors, then you get on a level where you can look past them, sort of ignore them, even though they're definitely still there in front of you, and see that there's beauty on Dartmoor, like the geometricness of it, how the hills hide things, how the light of the shining through the clouds highlights things. Look at this. How geography mixes in with that. And there's lots of different beautiful things you can read into Dartmoor once you get past that stage. So, yeah, there's a little bit of a ramble for you while I'm walking. What was that? Five steps, five different ways you can look at hiking in the countryside. By me. Enjoy. an off-track thing. A walkway that comes up this side of the track. Let's just pop up on top and see what's there. I thought I was going to get a view. I can see Great Lakes ahead, but we'll see a lot of it anyway. Aerial view up there. Might be a way up Great Mountain from here. There's a better view here. Different angle of Great Lakes and Little Lakes too. Back in the shade. Just notice there's a turn-off track here. Oh no, it's a crossroads. Is it a crossroads? No. No, maybe it's not a crossroads. I mean, there are little animal tracks down there, but it's not a proper track. It just ends, but there's certainly two tracks, I think, off here. One goes up Great Mountain, I think. The other one might go down to the edge of the River Lynn. Walk along it. Today that Kingway extended all the way up to that U-turn. I thought it was just the tramway U-turning, but obviously it's two different tracks. So this is Kingway. We're going to have to rename the video to not just Routbrook Tramway, but Kingway and five ways to see the landscape when hiking. Oh, give me some of that sunshine. We got that mining bridge thing coming up. Now I'm going to see it from below because I've just been reminded of something. Yes, yes. Are you liking this video so far? Okay, ooh. There's the mining bridge. Yeah. And there's a bit of flat here. So, confession time. Last video. What did we do? Last Moorwalk video? What was that? Well, that was trying to get to Blackatoor Copse Boulders, wasn't it? I think it was around about then I said, next time I come out, I'll have to come out with the tarp. And this is where I was thinking of putting the tarp. Not in there, but nearby. We would have been walking over that. Are those girders underneath? Yeah. That metal girders keeping up the track up there. Probably would have put the tarp somewhere around here, and to be honest, it doesn't look like a bad day for it. If I added a bit more weight to my bag, which would have been annoying, but yeah, this looks pretty good. It's actually dry pretty much, and there's some flat space around this bridge, and I would have just put the tarp around here, I think, and tried to get some sunshine, enjoy the views, have some food, that sort of thing. I will get around to doing that. It'll probably be in a different place on Dartmoor now, later in the year, if I set up camp somewhere. But yeah, this is quite a nice little spot. Just off from what is not the Routbrook Tramway, just off from Kingway, which we're now going to go back onto. Up the slope. Wood on top. Glad that it's metal underneath, to be honest. Not that it's a long way to fall or anything. Which one of those is woodcock tour? There's a lot of glitter all over the place there. It's quite hard to discern where it was. I think it might be that because it's just under Grin tour. Size of rock. I mean, there's the one that the tree's sticking out of over there. That's kind of like a glittery bunch of rock. And then various spoiled path things down here.
got some cavey looking rocks down here.
Is it tall?
No, that's too small, but
yeah, all these boulders, quite a lot of them around here.
There might be something down there as well.
I wonder if anyone even goes down there.
No landmarks or anything.
Maybe someone who lives down there and then wants to get onto this would walk up past that, but that's like the only person or small group of people who'd do it. Another part of the nature phase I was talking about, you know, the five phases thing. One of them is how humans have shaped all of the landscape and you can't find anything natural. Well, there's still places that over time become places that humans don't ever go just because of non-popularity. So that might be one of those. Who walks down there? Why would you walk down there? You could get from here to the Granite Way, I suppose. There's an awful lot of broad ground there. Some routes through it just might not be traversed at all. Like nature, like non-human nature reclaims it. So I don't get, like, when I was working in a Whole Foods shop, it's like some people would ask you, is this natural? Like holding up a drug or a remedy or something. And I just always have a puzzled expression on my face, like, what do you mean by natural? Because it could mean anything. It's one of those undefinables, really. Is this at all? No.
Oh, look at that. Sun's hitting Great Northern now.
We got to here. It's 2 o'clock, so that's been 1 hour. So I'd say maybe it'd be 2 hours trip there, 2 hours back, we'll see. See what time it is at the end of the Rattlebrook. How about you tell me what audio bars we have, there we go.
I recognise this place we're in.
On the five phases, the age of exploration phase. This is a little bit like that. It's not only to do with geography of the moor and the landscape you go to and what you learn over time about where you are. It's also geometry. Like, you look at a place, maybe someone takes a photo of it and shows you and goes, where's this on Dartmoor? And you're like, I know where that is on Dartmoor, because you recognize the fall of the land. You know, if it's high on the right like that
for a certain amount and then low on the left for a certain amount and there's a tiny landmark there and the ground of a certain kind,
you're like, I know where that is. So you get used to the geometry, not just the geography, if you know what I mean. You could just teleport me somewhere on Dartmoor, into a valley somewhere, and ask me to guess, like GeoGuessr or something, where are you on Dartmoor? And stood there and looked around for a little bit, I'd be like, yeah, I know where I am. Whereas when I started out, I didn't know what any of this geometry meant, you know, how you could easily guess where you were just from like the slope you're on and things like that. The other day, my penultimate driving lesson, which I haven't done a debrief vlog for because I passed my test. Got one driving lesson left with my instructor before all that's over. yeah, I went to Lisgard and I thought, hey, this is going to be a mysterious place, so I'd like to go there for the challenge to test myself. So I think it might be worrying if I like found a car in somewhere like Lisgard and couldn't drive back with it. But I drove there and it turned out wasn't that bad. It was a dry, sunny day, admittedly, but it was not that bad, and it didn't take as nearly as long as I think it would take. It's like under an hour to get there. So yeah, Age of Exploration might be transported into roads for me next. We'll have to see what happens.
The trench has emerged off to the right here. Oh, and there's a nice little pond. A tiny little pond. And the track there seems to go off to the valley before the sounds of course. Something on fire over there, maybe.
Is this a door? Sort yourself out, Ribbon. Yeah. I have not seen another person since I've been out here. Seems like there's nobody. Is there anybody? Nobody walking the moors here but me today. I have not seen anyone.
Just up there approaching now. Let's see where our track kind of doesn't go to the top of the hill. It goes
just like there and stops. Just like the bay thing where there's a U-turn. We'll be going up there. It's kind of weird though, because it's like a car parking bay. It's like, oh, well, what used to be there? I wonder if it was mining railway turnaround turntable thingy or something.
Some kind of water runoff to the left of the track.
Must come from up here somewhere. Yeah, there's some water flowing around here. Seems to go up there. If it's part of the lid. Here we go, boys. Boys and girls, my dudes. This is where the Kingway terminates, apparently, and becomes Rattlebrook Tramway if you come back on yourself. And you can kind of see it's like a car parking bay on Dartmoor. It's quite odd. If you go to the end of it and turn left, obviously, we walked that. At one point, can't remember when we walked it, but we walked it to get to the Sowerton tours, maybe after finding Woodcock tour. Yeah, look, just looks like perfect for cars to pull into. Love how the sky is reflecting the puddles, to be fair, it's kind of cool. So we just walked that. And we're going to walk this. Rattlebrook Tramway time.
Here I've seen my first humans. I've seen my first human beings.
There they are. Human beings, they're all out now.
Be careful, there's human beings now.
Welcome to the Rattlebrook Tramway on the western side of Dartmoor. Is this a tour? Have you seen a lot of boulders and I'm going to be probably annoying the fuck out of you by pointing to them. It's... No.
Lots of river lid tributary action here.
Oh no, oh man.
Too many.
Yeah. In fairness, I don't think any of these are at all. But there are a lot of boulders around here. And if there were enough, if they were big enough and there was enough of them, I'll be saying that in a more serious fashion.
Tributary stuff here.
Now, is this the actual river lid or just a tributary? Maybe that's the one that flowed past us when we were down on the other track. Lovely white clouds, cumulus, blue skies, and this kind of spring moorland ground. This will be all green in summer, but right now it's kind of like a desert. Desert in the rain and cold.
Those walkers I saw, God
catching up with me. They're just down there now. They're like so high speed. I think they've got big backpacks on as well. They're gonna catch up with me in no time. Why are they like almost running through Dartmoor?
Who can play that game?
No Stenger tour though, you can actually reach it fairly easily. G-Nods, G-Links, he'll go into hiding in a minute behind the track, then he'll pop out. I think where these two boulders are, either side of the track, is where the actual river lid is. In fact, I think I can hear it. Yep. Yeah, boys. Here's the real river lid. So the sources are there somewhere. I've never been to the source of the river lid. I'm not sure I'd want to go to a river source. I think I'd be wading through horrible terrain, maybe. It's still quite big here. I thought it was smaller up here. It's not that small. Comes from up there. I guess before whoever built the tramway built it, the river just went over the moor here. And then they must have, there's another one there for some reason. Plastic, that one. Must have had to reroute it for a time when they were building the path. Must have flooded somewhere around here when they were doing that. Back hurts a little bit at the moment. Muscular ache, middle. Left of spine, and here somewhere. Just taking a tiny sit down opportunity. I've not been pursued. I think the couple went off to Sowerton Tours, the only people I've seen today. Anyway, here we are at the base of Gren Tor. I have a feeling if I tried to get to Gren Tor from here, I'd be cut off by a bunch of bog. That's not the goal for today anyway. So we keep going. That's a War of the Worlds reference.
Ugly brutes! Dear God, what ugly brutes!
And then, if you see that, it's coming out again. Now I'm thinking it though. I have to get Elon Musk with his Neuralink to get that out of me. Or I could just say it. That is that a bit of Woodcock Tor? Actual tour, by the way, Woodcock Tor. Is that a bit of it though? Or was it down there?
I don't think the one with the tree. I don't think that's it. There's a bend in the track.
Sun's come out of my hands, dude, in this icy wind. It's starting to get a little bit too cold.
you, pistol packing, itchy finger, trigger happy, try to trap me, being rap, why you tap me, backstab me, break the faith, pull from grace, tell me lies, time flies, close your eyes, come with me. Trust you, you never hurt me. Now I'm disgusted, just adjusted. Certainly you fooled me, ridiculed me, left me hanging. Now shit's boomeranging, right back at ya. Big old range, narrow minded, left me blinded. I co-signed it, shit had fired, but I'm bouncing back. I grind it, now I'm in with better pressure. You comprehend me, you want to end me. You offend me, it's drama, feel the trauma. Come with me.
Articulated crane, mechanical pneumatic device. Anyway, it's 3 o'clock, my dudes. 1500. I'm just shy of the end of the Ratbrook tramway. I'm gonna go to the end. There's some junk. I can't remember what's at the end. That stuff.
This here is the turning.
So if you want to go off to Green Tor and the Bleak House ruins and the Donegoat tours, you can actually see Green Tor coming out right now. Don't know if there's something behind it, but there you go. There's something behind it. I think it might be lined up with Fir Tor behind it, actually. You might have seen Fir Tor there in the background. Look at the steep bank down here. Oh, the shade's come back. Every time the shade comes back, the wind gets cold and my hands start to freeze. So I'm going to tuck you away until the next sunshine comes or until we see something. There you go, guys. The wind's still kind of icy here, but I think it's because the lay of the land with this steep bank here is like somehow promoting the wind to hit this track quite hard. Splash off me. So it's just icy because of where we are, I think. We'll change that in a bit when we get back up there, and I'll throw you some ending clips, I'm sure. Look at this barren, cream-coloured wasteland. Very deserty, prairie-looking. Should film a western on Dartmoor, I reckon. I reckon you could do that. Look at the quality of this track here, though. Even the stones in it are like smooth, flat. Jesus. That's some high quality flattened earth there. It's got like sand in it and stuff. It's all clean. Yeah, so I don't quite remember what's at the bottom there, but between there and Kitty Tor flagpole, there's a load of boggy areas. It's kind of like managed bogs, I think.
Beautiful water there.
Some lensing going on. Yeah, there's like just here there's like some, it's kind of like a some sort of nature reserve bit or something. There's like managed bogs. They have like duck boards between the bogs so you can cross in different places. I think that's at the end of my Kitty Tor video, whichever one that is. Hunt Denga Woodcock Kitty Tor. The video is called something like that. I love these little clean runoffs here. It's crystal clear water. I don't know, maybe I'm getting distracted at things that other people don't appreciate, but love seeing it when I'm at the beach too, you know, just looking at a rock pool or something, or some flow over the sand, and there's like lensing, optical lensing going off, breaks the light up. There's like bricks here now.
Even some red bricks.
Sideways bricks in the road. A wooden bridge.
What's this bridge look like? Is it just wood?
No idea what this brook is called. This stream here. Does it have a name? Anyway, diggers like to hang out here. So it's a bog maintenance site. There's actually like, there's like a Land Rover here. Is there someone here today? There's like girders and stuff. I don't think I'll be able to get across this big body of water here to see those, but there's like some waste, rusting girders and things coming out. Yeah, I think I ran out of my second battery, so I'm on my last battery now, my dudes. But yeah, I've managed to get across. There's like a, some weird girders in this pit thing.
Oh, that used to be.
Oh look, there's some frog spawn just on the surface of the grass here. How weird. It's not in a pond or anything. Why would it be here? Weird frog behaviour.
Yeah, it's like a kind of spoil pond. You can see the Donegan Tors just there. Their names. Bleak House Ruins, I don't know if you can see that.
Of bricks as well. It used to be a building, I suppose. And that looks like a army Land Rover or something. So I wonder if the people up camping on the hill are like army people. Well, let's go and see what this is. Oh, I don't know if we'll be able to get across to it. Actually, probably had to do bog hopping to get down from it in that other video. Yeah, it's all boggy here. It's probably in that other video. And there is Kitty Talk Top. You have to figure out what that flag is. Alright, my dudes, that's the end of the Rattlebrook Tramway and Kingway. That's where we visited today. We did no tours, that wasn't the purpose of the vid. But yeah, a nice little walk through ice cold shade and quite nice sunshine. Thank you for watching.